Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. On the Healing Bench today, we have this. And it's a Meta Quest 2 controller. The problem with this is it does not power up. A customer has sent this in for us to have a quick look at. This is going to be a journey of discovery, more than an actual certified repair. If we do get it repaired, brilliant. But otherwise, I'm not holding out too much hope. So, when you put a battery in one of these, we should get a light round about here to signify that the controller is on. And according to the customer, that does not happen. So let's get a battery in him. And we've got a Duracell rechargeable. We will just check that on the multimeter to make sure that it is charged. It should be about 1.2 volts. 1.3 volts, and for a rechargeable battery, that is charged. We will just check these contacts out, and they look clean. Both ends are spring loaded, springing back. So, put in the battery, and we get absolutely nothing. Like I said, there should be a light here. Yeah, completely dead. So it looks like we need to take this apart, and these are not for the faint-hearted. So you guys know the drill, I'll speed run it. Okay, that was a bit of an ordeal to get that off. It was mainly down to the screws that were under here. So felt that there was something there, but I didn't realise that there was something like right up in this top edge here, and that was stopping this from coming away. So yeah, now that's done, we've got access to the battery compartment. And we've got access to the main board, so we can connect this back up again, and then we can try and measure some voltages and see what we get. Okay, so we've got that connected. Just pull this sticker off completely for now. Put in the battery. Oh, hello, we've got a light. We now have a light. Can you see that? Okay, so this is now powering up. I'm wondering if there was something wrong with this ribbon cable. I wonder if there's anything going on with that. Let's check it out under the scope. And here's the ribbon cable itself, and it looks in good condition. Looks fine. Let's have a look here. Shouldn't worry about that. That's just factory flux. As you can see, it sort of flakes off. That's 110% flux. What's going on there? No, that's just more flux. What have we got here? I think that's a haptic feedback of some sort. And the connections in there all look perfect. They all look good. Solder joints for the battery. They all look okay. I'll just give them a quick flow just in case. I mean, they don't look cracked. There's something on that one, maybe. That just flux. It's going to be flux. No, it's not flux, but there's definitely a line there. I don't know if that's a reflection, but we will just give these a quick reflow. Like so. And the same with the ground. Okay, that's good enough. I'm not entirely sure what I've done here to actually get this thing to power back on, other than just manhandle it and take it apart. So that's a bit of a frustrating fix. The only other thing I could think of is this ribbon cable or those solder joints. Just take a quick look at this side. I mean, I know that when you're playing Quest, you can get quite hot and sweaty. Of course, you're holding these. Maybe some sort of moisture could get in there. I'm not entirely sure. But everything looks perfectly fine. And there's no evidence of ingress of liquid or moisture or anything like that. No, it all looks fine. All the connectors are where they should be. By the way, there's the analog stick. It's very similar to a Switch Joy-Con analog stick. If you do have any stick drift issues with these controllers or any other VR controller, we do actually have these. So get in touch if you want us to repair your VR controller. Okay, let's just try that again. I'm just going to remove this battery before plugging in that cable. Try it again, just keep a lookout here. Should see a light. Yeah, we've got a light. Yeah, it's fine. Right. Okay, if I just keep holding that and move this cable around, do we get anything that's disconnecting? No. All seems fine. Okay, well, I would deem that a fix. It must have been just a dodgy connection somewhere. Manipulating this ribbon cable and or those solder joints for the battery connections, I'm not entirely sure, so I'll speed run the reassembly. And there we have it. One repaired Quest 2 controller. Again, I'm a little bit puzzled on exactly how it was fixed. The only thing that I can think of is down to that ribbon cable going from the battery compartment to the main board. While I was in there, decided to just resolder those battery connections just in case. But yeah, we have a light. It's now working. It's all good. So that will conclude that. If you have any problems with controllers, consoles, or any other device that you think we can help you with, please get in contact. All the contact details are in the description below. As always, hope you enjoyed the video and take care.